Hey guys, how are you? This is the Justin Bieber version of Cold Water from The Ellen Show. Going over the live versions, this is, I would say, the second best one. I like the one with Dan Cantor better, but the guitar part on the Dan Cantor version is a little bit more involved than this one. This one's not easy though, and I'm going to go over a couple things before we start. I've looked at a lot of the chord charts, and for Justin's version, they're not the same as what you will find online. Justin's going to play, instead of a minor chord on the first chord, he's going to play an F major 7. Now, F major 7 and D minor are similar, but there is still a difference. There will be times when Justin will play four strings, and then later in the song he'll add the fifth string open, which is an F major 7 with A in the bass. Your second chord will be C, straight up C major. Your third chord will be G, and it's going to be this G, the to the right G, I like to call it, because he does that little technique. When he goes to G, many times he'll play string 6, 3 and 2, and then he'll strike string 1, I'm assuming with the A finger, third finger of the right hand. The last chord in most of the chord charts I saw was a major, but it's really A minor. It's going to be a bar chord on fret 5. This is not real hard to do, but once again, like I say on almost every tutorial that involves bar chords, work on the bar chords first, because he does the same thing he does on the G chord. He'll end it with the first string, kind of like a strum, like a chord and then a melody note on top. That little move, but we'll get to that later. Let me see if there's anything else. Okay, the strumming part. Justin does not use a pick. He does what I like to call the fake pick. Really like this technique, but I've gotten accustomed to it, so you may want to practice that a little bit. I tend to go with the back of my nail like that, but he does this to get a little bit more force out of his strums. And there will also be the tap technique. Okay, let's get to the music and start with the intro. So Justin will strum the intro. F major 7, C, G, A minor. F major 7, G, A minor. Notice the tap technique. Since we're doing the fake pick, my tapping is coming from the heel of my hand, just like that. You see how I'm coming down? I'm hitting with this part of my hand a little bit. The back of my nail strikes the strings, but it's mainly the heel of my hand to give it that extra pop. I'm picking closer to the neck just to get a softer sound for the first verse. So I'm using all four of my fingers to strike the G, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110, 111, 112, 113, 114, 115, 116, 117, 118, 119, 120, 121, 122, 123, 124, 125, 126, 127, 128, 6-4-3 and 2 strings. Then I strike the first string with my middle, and then same thing with A minor. Just like that. Kind of have to be careful here so you don't snap the strings like that. So that's your verse progression. Now let's go to the Almighty pre-chorus. On Take a Deep Breath and Let It Go, he'll hit the G, the melody note, and then he'll switch to string 6, 3, 2, and 1. Then he'll strike the A minor, like that. Then the last line, You Shouldn't Be Fighting on Your Own, he stays away from the first string on C and A minor. During the pre-chorus, he gets away from that melody note on G and A minor and goes pretty much straight up. Then on the last line, I will still be patient with you. He'll hold the A minor, and I hope you. Then there's that G chord. And then you move into the chorus. In verse 2, he also avoids the melodic embellishments on the chords. Be careful here, because on the pre-chorus, the second pre-chorus, Justin starts to add the bass notes into the chords. We'll do it slowly. F major 7 with A, C with an E in the bass, G with G in the bass, A minor, A in the bass. So just be careful now. Be aware that he goes for the bass notes. It's a pretty cool idea. It's a little tricky if you're not used to it, so make sure that you target the right notes. Then, the really cool part of the song, Justin does a guitar solo in quotes with the chords where he changes up the rhythm. So you can hear he gets that little syncopated accent. So F, C. At the end of C and A minor, which are the second and fourth chords of the progression, Here's the right hand strumming. I go down, up, and tap. They're all down strokes until the last one. Like that. That's leaving out. I'll add the other rhythms. But you really got to come down on this string. To really kill the sound of those strings and produce that thud on the guitar body. He does that three times and then launches back into the pre-chorus, but really lays back on the pre-chorus. We don't go to a chorus, so this is where the song's going to end. We go back to a laid-back pre-chorus, really laid-back. The last chord in the pre-chorus going to hit the A major 7, play strings 5, 4, 3, and 2, which, if you remember, will be F major 7. Well, really now it's going to be F major with an A and a bass, because you don't have the open E, so it's not a major 7. So I'll label it on the chart as F slash A. Just like that. And the song ends. So I hope that helps. I hope it's a somewhat easier version than the Dan Cantor version. Either version will work if you are playing for yourself or with a singer. Whichever one you choose will be fine according to where you think you are as a player. Don't overdo it. Start with the Justin version, which is not easy by any means. He actually plays really well on it. Then move up to the Dan version if you feel like it. Okay, I'll be back with, I'm sure, another 1, 2, 3, or 4 of Justin's songs. Just be patient, and I'll put them up as soon as possible. Thank you very much, and any questions, fire away. Talk to you soon.